दोस्तों आज के मेहमान हैं एडवोकेट अमन दत्ता. ही इज एन एक्सपर्ट ऑन आर्बिट्रेशन. तो आप जानेंगे कि आर्बिट्रेशन कितना इम्पोर्टेंट रोल प्ले करता है, ना केवल रियल एस्टेट बल्कि सभी सेक्टर्स में ये बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट रोल प्ले करते हैं. नया सब्जेक्ट है. लेट अस वेलकम एडवोकेट अमन दत्ता. हाय अमन, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल एंड इट्स अ प्लेजर टू हैव यू.
हेलो सर, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर हैविंग मी सर. इट्स अ प्रिविलेज टू बी हियर एंड it's all the more special because of the fact that you and my dad go such a long way back, whether it's the EAP or NAR India. So I have very nice memories of you right from childhood. So it feels nice, sir, to be here in all of that context.
Sure.
Yes, sir.
Aman, let us begin with a short introduction of yourself. How did you get into this particular field and the law, this side, legal side of...
Right. Quite frankly, sir, there was not, I can be very honest, there was not too much thought into it. I was told, I think when I was in school, towards the end, by 10th standard or something, by my dad, that, you know, he suggested, why don't you do law? So, quite frankly, that was the starting point, so to speak. But after that, sir, what happened is in law college, my end goal was to get into conveyancing and real estate. Because that's what I had grown up and seeing. Yeah. But somewhere, sir, around fourth year, I started doing what you call moot court competitions. So, wo basically hota hi hai, sir, ki aap appear ho rahe ho. It's a mock competition. And you are appearing with the, basically arguing a case before a mock judge. A mock case, of course. And you're ranked based on that and you have to research and argue and so on and so forth. तो वो जब किया सर तो धीरे धीरे आई स्टार्टेड फीलिंग कि शायद इसमें मुझको ज्यादा इंटरेस्ट है. तो देन जो इंटेंशन इनिशियल था वो साइड में रह गया एंड आई प्रोसीडेड देन स्टार्टेड प्रैक्टिसिंग. आई वर्क विद हरियाणी एंड कंपनी. सो आई फिनिश्ड माय लॉ इन 2016. आई डिड द 5-year कोर्स फॉर माय एलएस लॉ कॉलेज. आई वर्क विद हरियाणी एंड कंपनी फॉर अबाउट 2 years, जस्ट अंडर 2 years, व्हिच इज इट वाज अ फेमस फर्म इन बॉम्बे.
Yes.
Yes, sir. And after that, I worked for... Yes, sir. Solicitors. After that, sir, I worked for AZB and Partners, which is another very big law firm in India, all over. I'm mostly known for corporate law. And after that, sir, I started out on my own in 2019. So that's been the journey thus far. And now I have my own practice. I appear before courts in Pune, Bombay, and even the Supreme Court in Delhi. So...
All right.
And even within that, now I've started specializing in arbitration work.
That is amazing. So,
yes,
2019 से लेके 2024 तक, so it's been about 5 years आप अपनी practice कर रहे हो.
Yes, sir. Almost 5 years. Almost.
So, Samir, ये arbitration is a very new subject. इसके बारे में थोड़ा बताइए. ये arbitration क्या होता है? What is arbitration?
Sir, arbitration is basically mode of alternate dispute resolution. Mane that usually hota aisa hai ki your regular private party disputes, they take place before a court of law. So irrespective of what the nature of the case must be, jo usual parlance mein bolte hain, a case of this kind would go to a civil court.
Okay.
Now, arbitration, sir, is simply it is no different from how a dispute would be tried before a court of law. The only difference in this case is that this is tried by a independent decision maker or a judge, jo parties khud select karte hain in most cases. And this decision maker or judge is going to decide the dispute privately. So in other words, this is to simply say that arbitration is the private mechanism of resolving disputes. So to take an example, if say A and B have entered into some kind of contract, A and B can agree that in the event any kind of disputes arise between us, that dispute will be referred to arbitration. And so the moment a dispute arises, if A wants to knock on the doors of the court, A court nahi jayega, A will go to the mechanism of arbitration. Of course, usme alag alag tarike hai to appoint the arbitrator itself. So that I will touch upon in detail. But by and large, this is what it is.
Okay. So this is an alternative to the to going to the court and appearing in front of the judges and things like that.
Yes.
ओके सो जैसे बोलते हैं कि एक तो म्यूचुअली सेटल करो और दूसरा आर्बिट्रेशन लेके एक आदमी दोनों का सुनेगा और देन ही विल गिव अ जजमेंट कि क्या सही है क्या गलत है कैसा होना चाहिए.
यस बेसिकली दैट्स व्हाट इट इज बट उसमें होता ही है. आई विल जस्ट क्लैरिफाई द कॉन्टेक्स्ट वंस कि देयर इज आर्बिट्रेटर. पहली बात तो 1, 3, 5 कितने भी हो सकते हैं एज लॉन्ग एज द नंबर इज नॉट एन इवन नंबर. दैट इज द फर्स्ट थिंग. Usually what we see is that in cases which involve big entities or companies and so on and so forth, un cases mein arbitration clause usually aisa structured hoga ki it will appoint for, it will provide for appointment of 3 arbitrators. So, okay. A person A will appoint the first arbitrator, his or her arbitrator. Person B will appoint his or her arbitrator. And then the two will come together and appoint a third arbitrator who is now called a presiding arbitrator.
I see. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. And इसमें then whatever is decided, ये तीनों मिलके जो भी decision लेंगे वो binding होगा दोनों के ऊपर.
Yes, that decision will be binding, sir.
Okay.
The of course Act Arbitration and Conciliation Act of 1996 जो है, which governs arbitrations, that provides for appeals also. So it is not as if arbitration हुआ and decision aa gaya and that is binding in the sense that binding in the sense ki wo aap directly usko execute kar sakte hain aisa nahi hai. As soon as an award is passed, the judgment which is passed by the arbitrator is called an award.
Yeah,
as soon as the award is passed, the party against whom the award has been passed can file a challenge to the award, as they call it, and then this challenge can be subjected to a further appeal also. So in essence, there are 3 rounds, so to speak, of appeal even after the award is passed.
I see.
But yes, so that is something that a lot of people don't necessarily know. क्योंकि arbitration के बारे में जब बात करते हैं in the public domain, तो होता ही है कि सब बोलते हैं it is a very speedy means of resolving disputes, which it is, no doubt. It is very efficient, which it is, no doubt. But it is not as as rosy as it's made out to be. There are further appeals,
right? But that is very important.
Yes, fortunately, sir, however, hota ye hai in most cases. I will give you an example also of why this actually might work, or why it works rather. Jab ek arbitrator ka award pass ho jata hai finally. Now, in most cases, one will assume that the award has been passed after really examining the case, the merits, and so on and so forth. Once the award has been made, usually, कोई ना कोई party challenge तो करेगी उस award को. Now, the moment that award has been challenged, there is one provision in the Arbitration Act which says that in most cases where the award is to pay a certain amount, the party who is challenging must deposit either the full amount or some part of that amount, that the court will decide, the court which is hearing the appeal or challenge to the award. Ab isme hota ye hai ki most cases mein, unless koi grave exceptional error dikh jata hai arbitration award mein, judgment mein, to court will usually direct ki aap xyz amount deposit kariye. What the court will also do is allow the other party to withdraw this amount, whether wo bank guarantee mange shayad court, yeah, unconditionally withdraw karne de. That is, of course, all technical issues, case to case basis. But by and large, court will permit that. What that does is then it discourages further litigation or appeals. Because aap arbitration mein cost already kafi incur kar chuke hain. Once the award has gone against you now, unless and until you have very deep pockets, and unless and until you are very certain that your case is a very, very strong one, usually you know, prudent person at that time will say, "Theek hai, ab shayad sahi time hai, I should settle it," because interest keeps accruing.
Yeah.
Aur wo interest jo hota hai, wo element kafi zyada baad mein substantially high ho jata hai. So to give you context, we did, in fact, this was my first thaga arbitration. So wo aisa hua tha that it was a very complex dispute. It was in relation to a thermal power plant. And we were representing one of the subcontractors. वहां पे हुआ ऐसे कि आर्बिट्रेशन हुआ एंड जो सामने वाली पार्टी थी they were a huge conglomerate, they still are. And तो वो आर्बिट्रेशन चला, इट वेंट ऑन फॉर अबाउट 3.5-4 years or whatever.
Okay.
And finally, the award was passed in favor of our clients.
Okay.
The moment the award was passed, the other side filed an appeal also. And the appeal came up for hearing. So after, and by parallelly, we were trying to execute the award. So we were, you know, it was in that stage. And at that time, सामने वाली पार्टी ने, when they were directed to deposit money, वो सामने से आके उन्होंने they discussed settlement and so on and so forth, and वहाँ पे आके they finally settled the matter. तो to a lay person होता ऐसे है कि one feels that arbitration is efficient, which means that you know in 6 months my dispute is resolved just like that. It is, but the context is our regular court system. जहां पे आपके सो देयर इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग, प्रिवी काउंसिल जो पहले होती थी, इट वाज वन ऑफ द अर्लीस्ट कोर्ट एस्टैब्लिशमेंट्स अपनी कंट्री में इन द ब्रिटिशर्स टाइम. प्रिवी काउंसिल ने किसी एक जजमेंट में ऑब्जर्व किया था कि द बिगेस्ट द वरीज ऑफ अ लिटिगेंट व्हिच इज अ पार्टी, वो शुरू होती है वंस ही ऑब्टेन्स अ जजमेंट. बिकॉज सिविल केसेस आपको जजमेंट मिल जाएगा ठीक है, बट देन दैट जजमेंट हैज टू बी एग्जीक्यूटेड ऑल्सो. तो एक केस, एक टेस्ट केस अगर आप लें, एक सिंपल टेस्ट केस फॉर रिकवरी ऑफ मनी. सो मुझको अगर सपोज कुछ अमाउंट रिकवर करना है, मैं कोर्ट जाता हूं आफ्टर 6-8 हाउ मेनी एवर इयर्स इट माइट टेक, मुझको जजमेंट मिल जाता है. नाउ आफ्टर द जजमेंट हैज बीन पास, द अदर साइड हैज द राइट टू फाइल एन अपील. वो अपील चलेगी, अज्यूम फॉर अ सेकंड दैट उसने अपील नहीं की फॉर व्हाटएवर रीजन, या देयर इज सम समथिंग ऑफ दैट काइंड, सम सिचुएशन लाइक दैट. I will still have to file a decree, a proceeding for execution of that judgment and decree. Jiska matlab ye hai ki ab wo parallel hi chalega. Now, sure, paper aisa kaida ye bolta hai ki execution has to happen swiftly, so on and so forth. But even within that, there are 100 different things that a creative person can do to keep prolonging that. So, ye compared to that, arbitration becomes a lot more efficient.
Yeah. And how is it cost-wise? Isme court se kharch kam hota hai? Ya utna hi hota hai?
Nahin. Arbitration is, when you compare it to regular court litigation in that sense, in the short term, expensive.
Okay.
Because, yes, for the simple reason that once the dispute is going to be resolved in a speedy, efficient, time-bound manner, so on and so forth, how do you incentivize it? So first thing is that arbitrator's fees. Now, a lot of parties don't know this, but when they agree on the fact ki agar hamare beech mein koi dispute hota hai, toh we will refer it to arbitration. What they can do at that time is agree beforehand that by and large, these are the arbitration fees that will be payable. Now, these are all slightly gray areas, but nevertheless, that is an option. Because arbitration ki sabse badi jo ek khasiyat hai ya advantage jo hai, bolte hai, that is that parties can by and large choose ki humko kaise karna hai, hamari dispute resolve. In law, we call it party autonomy. That said, by and large, in most arbitrations, hota hi hai ki the Arbitration and Conciliation Act of 1996, it provides for schedule of fees, a model schedule of fees, which is called the fourth schedule. So for a dispute up to 20 lakhs, there is some stipulated about 97,500. So that will have to be paid to the arbitrator as arbitration fees. Above 20 lakhs, there is another cap, and so on and so forth. There are about five different brackets. Arbitration fees can go up in that sense. If you are to count the upper limit of the fourth schedule, 30 लाख तक भी जा सकती है. बट दोज आर इन केसेस वेयर आपके क्लेम्स भी, बिकॉज सर आर्बिट्रेशन यूजुअली होता ही है कि इज इन्वोक्ड इन केसेस वेयर 1000 करोड़ डिस्प्यूट्स आर इन्वॉल्वड और देयर इज सम काइंड ऑफ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर अग्रीमेंट और सम अदर काइंड ऑफ सच अरेंजमेंट बिटवीन टू बिग कॉर्पोरेट्स और कॉन्ग्लोमरेट्स, एंड सो द स्टेक्स आर सो हाई. सो नेचुरली देन अमाउंट ऑफ डॉक्यूमेंट्स दैट द आर्बिट्रेटर विल हैव टू गो थ्रू, दैट इज ऑल्सो दैट काफी कुछ होता है. सो कीपिंग ऑल दीज थिंग्स. एक और चीज जो हैज टू बी केप्ट इन माइंड इज दैट आर्बिट्रेशन कॉस्ट डजंट जस्ट इंक्लूड आर्बिट्रेटर्स फीस. योर आर्बिट्रेशन हियरिंग जो होती है दैट हैपन एट सर्टेन वेन्यूज. Okay. So unless the parties are using one of their own premises or offices or whatever as a venue, uski bhi ek alag cost hogi, which has to be borne in. Eventually, arbitration, most cases mein, will be awarded to the winning party. So, Achha. You have what you call the loser pays principle, jo humare act mein embody kiya gaya hai, which says that the party who is winning should be compensated towards whatever expense he or she may have incurred to recover his or her rightful dues. So most cases, the losing party will be directed ki aapko costs bhi inko reimburse karne honge. So that's as far as the cost element of it is concerned.
This is amazing understanding, Aman, kyunki आर्बिट्रेशन का ये जो सब्जेक्ट है ये तो हम हमेशा हर एग्रीमेंट में सुनते आए हैं कि बोथ पार्टीज विल रिफर टू एन आर्बिट्रेटर. लेकिन एक्चुअली yes. होता क्या है ये मैं नहीं समझता कि बहुत ज्यादा लोगों को पता है. इवन आई हैव नेवर इन माय लाइफ फेस्ड एनी आर्बिट्रेशन और एनी ऑफ माय क्लाइंट्स हैव गॉन इनटू एनी आर्बिट्रेशन या कोई लीगल डिस्प्यूट में. सो दिस इज वेरी नाइस टू अंडरस्टैंड कि किस तरह ये फंक्शन करता है और क्या क्या इसके. सो टेल मी अमन, इसमें एक सवाल मेरा ये है कि आर्बिट्रेशन के बेनिफिट्स क्या है एंड ये हाउ इज इट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द लिटिगेशन और ए रेगुलर कोर्ट केस.
सर, आई विल टेल यू द बेनिफिट्स आल्सो एंड द डिसएडवांटेजेस आल्सो, बट वी विल ऑफ कोर्स स्टार्ट विद द बेनिफिट्स फर्स्ट. फर्स्ट बेनिफिट सर इज दैट अनफॉर्चुनेटली जो हमारा कोर्ट सिस्टम है आज के दिन में होता ही है कि व्हेन वी आर आउटसाइड ऑफ द लॉ, जब मैं मतलब एज व्हेन आई वाजंट अ लॉयर तो मुझे ऐसा लगता था कि आर कोर्ट सिस्टम इज वेरी स्लो, आर कोर्ट सिस्टम इज नॉट एफिशिएंट, यू नो केसेस आर जस्ट लाइंग पेंडिंग. इफ यू सी द स्टैटिस्टिक्स ऑन द अमाउंट ऑफ केसेस दैट आर पेंडिंग तो डिस्करेज हो जाता है. बट रीजंस फॉर दैट यूजुअली आर व्हाट पीपल विल से इज दैट यू नो लॉयर्स और जजेस आर नॉट नेसेसरली थिंकिंग ऑफ डूइंग इट एफिशिएंटली or 100 other reasons. But it's much deeper. The problem is much deeper because infrastructure is not there. If we see the conditions in which so many of our judges are working, it's a really sad state of affairs. Bolne ka maksad ye hai iska ki naturally jab system aisa hai to you cannot expect ki efficient disposal of cases hoga. Arbitration instantly shifts perspective. Why? Because ab there is either one or three, usually it will have three people, but ek ya teen log sirf aapka ek case decide karne baithe. So what that does is instantly there is a very different kind of focus to the case. It's a human element. Obviously the more the lesser you work you have before you, the more you will be able to apply your mind to it. So I'm in no way saying that judges are not applying their mind or anything like that. But at least that peace of mind is there to a client. Okay, fine. My case is going to be, by and large, decided with a very different kind of precision or focus or whatever you want to might want to call it. That's the first advantage. Second advantage is that it's very effective when it comes to time that it takes for disposal. तो जो आर्बिट्रेशन एंड कंसिलिएशन एक्ट है वो ऐसे बोलता है, वी विल टेक अ डोमेस्टिक आर्बिट्रेशन फॉर एन एग्जांपल, बिकॉज़ बाय एंड लार्ज दो तरह के आर्बिट्रेशन होते हैं, बट डोमेस्टिक आर्बिट्रेशन जो इंडियन आर्बिट्रेशन होता है बिटवीन टू इंडियन पार्टीज, एक्ट बोलता है कि इट हैज टू बी डन विद इन 12 मंथ्स एंड पार्टीज अग्री टू हैव इट डन बाय एक्सटेंड दैट 12 मंथ पीरियड बाय अनदर 6 मंथ्स, यानी कि 18 महीने में आपको कंप्लीट करना ही.
ओके okay.
That any extension that you want to take or any extension that might be required has to be taken from a court. So without permission from the court, you cannot continue proceedings beyond 18 months. So it very rarely happens, at least now in my experience over the last 7 years or so, ke extension ki zarurat padti hai. The case that I referred to, wahan padi thi hum. Like I said, wo 3 ya 4 saal chala, but there were valid reasons for that. And obviously, parties will not be happy ke itna lamba chalta hai, but they also knew that there were valid reasons. But ek normal, ordinary arbitration mein, 12 se 18 mahine mein aapka case dispose of ho jata hai. So that is, this in a regular court system could take 4 years, 6 years, 10 years, anything.
Yeah, yeah.
So that is the instant added advantage. Apart from that, what happens, sir, is that because the context of arbitration itself, if we see, read about it, it says arbitration is a form of alternate dispute resolution. So basically, matlab uska ye hua ki it is not necessarily like a traditional litigation. So instantly, somewhere subconsciously, wo context set ho jata hai. That okay, fine. That the possibility of settling it is not off the table. Right. So you will see eventually, inevitably in arbitrations, that arbitrators at some point will always tell the parties, you know, why don't you settle it? And so on and so forth. Because the arbitrator is performing that role in the background all the time. Right. So that is another advantage. And the last advantage that I would say is that, like I said, a regular court system, mein, your difficulties begin after you get the judgment. But in arbitration, even if it takes beyond 18 months, take for example, of course, there cannot be any guarantees. If the intent to settle is not there, then doesn't matter. But by and large, jaise hi aapke favor mein award aata hai, your chances of having the dispute settled even after that, at the appeal stage, are still much higher. Right? So, in that sense, by and large, to a person who is not, you know, very conversant with arbitration, I would say these are the four broad advantages. Disadvantages are very simple to list out. Costs of arbitration are still high. So, to a person who's, you know, not necessarily got a very big dispute to resolve, you know, our definitions of big and small are objective. But a dispute which is otherwise small, kisi aur ke liye, it can mean everything. So, in that sense, the cost of arbitration, wo ek thoda issue hai. But again, agar aap usko dekhte hain from an overall time perspective, I think it's still much more efficient. Apart from that, awareness jo arbitration related hai, wo zyada hai nahi. So now, of course, you have people trying to specialize, and not just as arbitration lawyers, but most important is the role of an arbitrator. Because if you have an arbitrator who knows the law, arbitration law, I mean, and if you have an arbitrator who genuinely wants to resolve the dispute, that intent is extremely important. That, you know, is very instrumental sometimes in whether an arbitration will go on for a long time or get settled earlier. So that, I believe, awareness needs to increase.
Yeah.
Apart from that, arbitration awards, jo judgment hote hain, those, of course, are not, they are not interfered with left, right, center by the courts. But abhi bhi aise hota hai. Law has brought about many amendments. The parliament brought about an amendment in 2015 mein ek aaya, 2019 mein ek aaya, for that matter, 21 mein bhi ek aaya. Where they are trying now to narrow down on the room for interfering with awards. But abhi bhi a judge inherently is sitting to judge, right? So, jab wo appeal mein award jata hai unke saamne, many a times maybe a judge is not able to restrain himself or herself. So, jaise ek appeal chalti hai, waise hi arbitration award ko bhi decide karte hain. Halanki the law says ki arbitration awards do not have to be decided like appeals in regular cases. Interference is very narrow, the scope for it. But these are things that will take time because why is of the act that we have now is the act of 1996. So essentially, it's not even 30 years old in that sense.
Yeah.
Now, of course, 30 years is a lot. But when you look at it in legal parlance, you have your contract act, jo Indian contract act, wo 1872 se hai.
British
contract. So, there is a lot of, yes, on the subject. But arbitration, jo current form mein jo act hai, wo 96 mein aaya hai. So, relatively, it's still newer, nascent stage mein.
So, Aman, in layman's language or understanding, arbitration, yes. जो लोगों को लगता है कि अरे एक arbitrator appoint कर दो और आपका काम easily हो जाएगा, so it is easily हो जाएगा, but पैसा लगेगा,
yes.
ज्यादा लगेगा court से, because ये easily हो रहा है, fast हो रहा है, fast track
yes.
हो रहा है.
Yes, so but उसमें cost जैसे आपने बताया.
हाँ. It is going to cost yes. them. So, yeah, this is something which viewers must know, and they also must know that arbitration kis dhang se kiya jata hai aur fair trial hoti hai, jaise courts mein hoti hai, usi tarah yahan bhi arbitrator appoint kiya jate hai aur usi tarike se ye sare cases run karte hai. Aur jaise aapne bataya ki 18 mahine ke andar, 12 se 18 mahine ke andar, they have to finish. Ideally, that is the yes. situation, unless they go further and in appeal.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
And so, I'll just touch upon over here. Yeah. How can an arbitrator be appointed?
Haan.
Because, jaise aapne bola ki, ek mindset kya hota hai? And I have seen this. And still hota hi hai ki every, at least every company will incorporate an arbitration clause. Wo apne agreement pe dal denge. उनका इंटेंट हो या नहीं, वो कितने बार आ जाते हैं, मतलब वो क्लॉजेस, क्योंकि कोई पुराना ही ड्राफ्ट होगा वो आपने पेस्ट किया है, वो क्लॉज उसका था, वो आ गया है. अब जब डिस्प्यूट होता है तो दे रियलाइज मेनी टाइम्स, दैट इज व्हेन दे रियलाइज कि इसमें आर्बिट्रेशन क्लॉज है. सो आई इनफैक्ट हैड एन एक्सपीरियंस रिसेंटली वेयर देयर वाज अ पर्सन हु हैड परचेस्ड फ्लैट्स, मेनी फ्लैट्स फ्रॉम ए पर्टिकुलर डेवलपर. And the developer wasn't able to deliver and so on and so forth. And काफी पैसा payment exchange हुआ था. तो अब वो dispute जब हुई तो जो client थे वो civil court गए. उन्होंने शायद कोई criminal case भी किए थे ये वो. But it took them almost 3 to 4 months. And this is actually a very good example, sir, of how effective arbitration can be. But उन्होंने civil court में कोई case file किया था. वो भी फॉर सम रीजन विड्रॉ कर लिया, काफी कुछ हुआ. आई वोंट गेट इनटू दैट. लॉन्ग स्टोरी शॉर्ट, व्हेन आई मेट देम, सो आई सॉ द एग्रीमेंट, उसमें आर्बिट्रेशन क्लॉज था. आई सेड कि यहाँ पे तो मतलब आप कोर्ट गए क्यों थे, बिकॉज यू हैव एन आर्बिट्रेशन क्लॉज. सो फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट दे वरंट अवेयर ऑफ इट, राइट? सो ऑफकोर्स दैट्स, दे आर नॉट टू ब्लेम फॉर दैट. हूएवर इट इज दैट मस्ट हैव एडवाइज्ड देम प्रीवियसली, दे हैड सम अदर आइडियाज मे बी, बट उन्हें पता ही नहीं था. तो उनको फिर आई टुक देम थ्रू द होल थिंग एंड सेड, लुक, यू विल हैव टू इनवोक आर्बिट्रेशन एंड दिस इज द बेनिफिट, दिस इज द डिसएडवांटेज. तो ये सितंबर में हमने पहले, वी वेंट टू द कोर्ट, बिकॉज इन आर्बिट्रेशन व्हाट हैपेंस इज, बिफोर यू स्टार्ट आर्बिट्रेशन, जिस कोर्ट के पास ज्यूरिसडिक्शन है टू सुपरवाइज द आर्बिट्रेशन, उस कोर्ट से आप इंटरिम रिलीफ भी मांग सकते हैं, which is in the nature of a temporary relief, जो stay बोलते हैं in common parlance.
हाँ.
So ऐसे किस तरह का relief we went and sought from the court, we got that. Instantly कुछ समय में arbitrator appoint हुआ, and arbitrator was a retired high court judge, so she entered reference, took over, we filed whatever our case was, the other side filed theirs. Long story short, sir, we I believe began in on 22nd August 2023. And on 16th April 2024, the parties had filed what you call consent terms.
Okay.
So, if it's conducted efficiently, and here the arbitrator ka role bahut important tha, because she was not, you know, usually jo tarikh pe tarikh type hote hai, that she was not allowing anyone to do, either us or them. So, she said, look, we have agreed that aap itne samay mein ye, itne samay mein ye. So, the trial will go on in terms of what we have agreed on. And like I said, 129 or less than 130 days, basically, that case was settled. So anyway, that's as far as the efficient part of it is concerned. I digressed, but I'll just touch upon how the arbitrator is appointed, because many people, like I said, aren't aware of that.
Yeah,
three modes as, or three ways of appointing. Exactly. So the first mode is ki aapka aur mera agreement hai, and some dispute arises between us, and main kehta hun, sir, dispute has arisen, XYZ ka name main propose karta hun, you please give your consent. Hum assume karte hain agreement mein ek sole arbitrator ka clause hai. यू गिव योर कंसेंट तो बात वहीं खत्म हो गई. वी आर बोथ म्यूचुअली अपॉइंटेड एक्स पर्सन. बट नाउ मोस्ट केसेस ऑब्वियसली व्हाट विल हैपन इज इफ आई से सम डिस्प्यूट एज अ रीजन एंड आई प्रपोज अ नेम, यू इन ऑल लाइकलीहुड विल नॉट अग्री टू इट फॉर टू रीजंस. वन, यू डोंट हैव फेथ इन हु हैव प्रपोज्ड, और सेकंड, you don't have any intention of resolving this dispute, so why should you proactively take steps? So in such a case, I have an option. मैं जा सकता हूँ. If assume कि हम पुणे से हैं, so dispute has happened in Pune. मैं जाऊँगा बॉम्बे हाई कोर्ट, and I will file a petition before the Bombay High Court. They have exclusive jurisdiction. Basically, to appoint an arbitrator in a domestic arbitration, only the High Court has powers.
अच्छा.
तो पुणे के केस में मैं बॉम्बे जाऊंगा एंड आई विल से देयर वाज एन एग्रीमेंट बिटवीन माय सेल्फ यस एंड यू नो डिस्प्यूट्स हैव अरिजन एंड सो यू प्लीज अपॉइंट द आर्बिट्रेटर. सो दैट्स द सेकंड मोड ऑफ अपॉइंटमेंट ऑफ एन आर्बिट्रेटर. तीसरा मोड ऐसे कि काफी बार ऐसे हो सकता है कि डिस्प्यूट्स अराइज बिटवीन अस, हमारे बीच में आर्बिट्रेशन अग्रीमेंट है, बट मैं चले जाता हूँ सिविल कोर्ट फॉर एग्जाम्पल. अगर मैं मान के चलिए आई फाइल अ केस इन द सिविल कोर्ट, वहां पे यू कैन अपियर एंड से दैट लुक हमारा अग्रीमेंट था, आर्बिट्रेशन क्लॉज है इसमें, तो सिविल कोर्ट का ज्यूरिसडिक्शन नहीं बनता है. तो इन सच अ केस देन द सिविल कोर्ट विल रेफर अस टू आर्बिट्रेशन. सो बाय एंड लार्ज दीज आर द थ्री मोड्स. दिस आई बिलीव इज वन ऑफ द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ आर्बिट्रेशन. आई मिस्ड आउट ऑन दिस. देयर इज नो रिजिड रूल, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है कि आर्बिट्रेटर एक रिटायर्ड या जज ही हो सकते हैं या कोई लॉयर ही हो सकते हैं. इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट.
ओके.
यू कैन हैव अ नॉन लीगल पर्सन सो टू स्पीक ऑल्सो एक्ट एज एन आर्बिट्रेटर, बट बिकॉज एंड द रीजन फॉर दैट इज वेरी सिंपल. देर आर सर्टन काइंड ऑफ डिस्प्यूट्स विच आर सो टेक्निकल के जिसके लिए आपको टेक्निकल एक्सपर्ट्स की जरूरत होती है. सो यू इट इज नॉट अनकॉमन कि यू हैव अकाउंटेंट्स, engineers, architects, or anyone jiski specialization hai, acting as arbitrators. But usme ek cheez aisi hai ki aapke jo arbitrator hote hain, assume karte hain ki aapne apne arbitrator ko nominate kiya hai, there are certain degrees of relationships. So the arbitrator cannot fall within any of those degrees of relationships. Because that is a clear cut case of bias, right? So yeah. There is दो शेड्यूल है आर्बिट्रेशन एक्ट में, फिफ्थ शेड्यूल एंड सेवेंथ शेड्यूल. सो आपको एज एन एग्जाम्पल अगर मैं बोलूं, वन ऑफ द एंट्री सेज द आर्बिट्रेटर इज अ क्लोज फैमिली रिलेटिव ऑफ यू नो ईदर द पार्टीज और द एडवोकेट्स अपीयरिंग और सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ. सो इन सच अ केस ऑब्वियसली सच पर्सन कैन नॉट बी एन आर्बिट्रेटर. बट बाय एंड लार्ज अगर फिफ्थ शेड्यूल या सेवेंथ शेड्यूल का वायलेशन नहीं होता है, and largely seven schedule is what is prohibited, agar wo up on that front compliant hai, so subject to that you can appoint anyone.
Okay, understand.
Yes, absolutely.
So mujhe aur ek baat bataiye Aman, mediation aur arbitration ke beech ka farak kya hai?
Sir, mediation and arbitration actually ek bahut again to somebody who is not practicing law, somebody who is not you know in the law as such, a lot of times I have seen people thinking that mediation and arbitration are the same things, but aapne sahi pakda hai, they are not the same things. Mediation is something which is relatively newer in its current form. Mane ki 2023 mein parliament ne mediation act of 2023 enact kiya. Now that also has an independent procedure ki aap kaise karenge agree on mediation. उसके लिए भी यू हैव टू हैव अ मीडिएशन अग्रीमेंट इन प्लेस एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ. यस. एंड डिफरेंस इन वन सेंटेंस ये है कि मीडिएटर कैन नॉट डिसाइड डिस्प्यूट्स, आर्बिट्रेटर कैन डिसाइड डिस्प्यूट्स.
आई सी.
राइट. सो इफ देयर इज अ डिस्प्यूट बिटवीन ए एंड बी एंड somebody एंड ए एंड बी अग्री के वी विल अपॉइंट यू, मतलब मिस्टर किशन मिलानी एज अ मीडिएटर, अगर वो आपको अपॉइंट करते हैं तो आपके पास पावर है टू डायरेक्ट ए एंड बी टू सिट डाउन, हैव अ डिस्कशन, एंड नॉट जस्ट डिस्कशन, यू कैन हैव इट प्रॉपरली एज इन फॉलोइंग प्रोसीजर. मे बी दे give some written submissions on their part. A gives his, B gives his, saying, this is what I think. B says, this is what I think. And you being an expert in that particular area, say, okay, fine, look, A, I've seen what you had to say. B, I've seen what you had to say. According to me, this is what I think is a fair, reasonable settlement that can be worked out. That is what a mediation is. If A and B agree on the solution presented by you, so then mediation pehli baat to obviously successful ho gaya. Second, ab mediation act jo aaya hai, uske under ek lamba chauda procedure hai. Ki that will, that settlement will be recorded under an agreement. फिर उस agreement को आप challenge कुछ exceptional cases में एक party कर सकती है, but by and large कोई नहीं कर सकता. Once you have signed on a mediated settled agreement. But decision-making power is missing. So that only, yes, and that can only happen under, that is only conferred on the arbitrator. Yes.
Okay.
So all right. That is, yes. And arbitration, just because a lot of people might hear or remember the word conciliation. So because Arbitration and Conciliation Act of 1996. So ye jo conciliation part hai, now that has been repealed by the Mediation Act. So ab aapka arbitration hai and mediation hai. And of course, other forms are also there. Ek naya hybrid jo form aaya hai, wo, that is called MedArbMed, which is basically stands for mediation, arbitration, and mediation.
I see.
Yes, and I have very strong views on that. I believe that is a very useful and revolutionary concept for the reason that आप मीडिएशन जब शुरू करते हैं तो इफ यू आर डूइंग इट प्रॉपरली एज ए मीडिएशन अंडर द लेट्स से मीडिएशन एक्ट विद द राइट स्पिरिट तो होता यह है कि आपको पता होता है ए को पता होता है बी का केस क्या है बी को पता होता है ए का केस क्या है अज्यूम दैट मीडिएशन नहीं चलता है फॉर व्हाटएवर रीजंस तो फिर इफ देयर इज अ मेड हाफ मेड क्लॉज तो पार्टी से कि चलो वी विल ट्राई मीडिएशन फॉर 60 डेज और व्हाटएवर 30 60 90 डेज नहीं चलता है तो वी विल गो टू आर्बिट्रेशन अब ए नोज बीस केस बी नोज एस केस दे गो टू आर्बिट्रेशन ऑल्सो नाउ इन आर्बिट्रेशन यूजुअली सर होता ही है कि टू स्टेजेस आई फील आर द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वन इज द एविडेंस स्टेज बिकॉज तब एक कॉमन पार्लेंस में बोलते हैं तो कच्चे चिट्ठे तब खुलते हैं दोनों खुलते हैं
ओके
ठीक है बोलना तो एक बात है बट अब वॉट इज द प्रूफ सो At the evidence stage, usually you will find the weaker party realizing the weakness of its case. And that is a very good time to strike and say, okay, fine, you know what? I'll give you one opportunity to mediate on this again. Because aapka utna samay arbitration related bachta hai. So if the clause is like a med-ab-med clause, that will permit a part, parties to say, ki chalo, humne mediation try kiya, fail hua. आर्बिट्रेशन में गए लेकिन अब हमको लगता है कि वी कैन सिट अक्रॉस एंड रिजॉल्व द डिस्प्यूट तो यू ऑटोमेटिकली हैव द ऑप्शन ऑफ गोइंग बैक टू मीडिएशन एंड दैट विल आई बिलीव इन मोस्ट केसेस बी मच मोर इफेक्टिव थैंक यू
वेरी नाइस अमन ये दिस इज अ न्यू टर्म दैट आई हैव नोन टुडे मेड अब मेड सो मीडिएशन आर्बिट्रेशन एंड मीडिएशन अगेन So, Aman, we've studied about arbitration, we've studied about mediation, we've studied about both now, and we have known it upsides and downsides. Now, tell me, what must be kept in mind while signing an arbitration in an agreement? जैसे कई लोग इसको लिख तो लेते हैं, लेकिन शायद उनके lawyer को ही पता होता है कि उसका मतलब क्या है. The parties do not actually understand its gravity. कई बार मतलब एटलीस्ट फॉरगेट अबाउट द कॉर्पोरेट्स दे हैव दैट एक्सपीरियंस लेकिन जो प्राइवेट पार्टीज को शायद इतना अनुभव इस चीज का नहीं होता है सो क्या ध्यान में रखना चाहिए बिफोर यू गेट मेंशन दिस क्लॉज इन द एग्रीमेंट
दिस इज अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन सर व्हाई बिकॉज देयर आर टू इश्यूज आर्बिट्रेशन में एक सीट एंड वेन्यू ऑफ आर्बिट्रेशन तो ये थोड़ा टेक्निकल है मैं ज्यादा उसमें नहीं जाऊंगा बट जस्ट फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ आंसरिंग योर क्वेश्चन आपने एक और चीज बोली दैट यूजुअली इफ देयर इज यू नो दीस कॉर्पोरेट्स दे विल प्रोबेबली नो व्हाट दे आर साइनिंग मेनी अ टाइम्स दे आल्सो ओनली फाइंड आउट व्हेन द डिस्प्यूट हैज अरिजन So, but by and large, जो आपका सवाल है, it is that what do you keep in mind? तो पहली बात तो ये कि we will assume कि जो example या test case हम लेते हैं, तो जिस पार्टी की हम बात कर रहे हैं, he or she is from say Pune or Mumbai. Let's take Pune for example. So if I am signing an agreement, what I will want is A, the seat of arbitration should be Pune. Why that's important is because if the seat is some other place, फिर उसमें issue ऐसे होता है कि जब arbitration शुरू होता है, तो अगर if you recollect at the beginning of this discussion, we spoke about going to the high court to appoint an arbitrator.
Yeah, yeah.
Now assume करिए for a second कि seat of arbitration for some reason दिल्ली है. तो अब मुझको आर्बिट्रेटर अपॉइंटमेंट के लिए दिल्ली हाई कोर्ट जाना है, बॉम्बे हाई कोर्ट से. फर्स्ट थिंग. सेकंड थिंग इज के सो दैट इज द फर्स्ट एंड आई थिंक मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट प्रीरिक्विजिट के आपका आर्बिट्रेशन होगा कहां पर, राइट? ये डोमेस्टिक कॉन्टेक्स्ट में बात कर रहा हूं. सेकंड थिंग इज कि यूजुअली आपके आर्बिट्रेशन अग्रीमेंट में क्लॉज होगा कि द आर्बिट्रल ट्रिब्यूनल एज इट्स कॉल्ड विल कंसिस्ट ऑफ 1, 3, or 5 arbitrators. Ab, again, this depends on the kind of dispute, but there is nothing wrong with having a sole arbitrator. Because when there are more arbitrators, aapka arbitration cost padta hai, first thing. Second thing is that apart from that time, because you have to then, hearings will be scheduled, keeping in mind tino arbitrators ka jo availability hai ya nahi hai, things like that. Toh wo ek important factor hai. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट जो आप फीस ऑफ आर्बिट्रेशन की बात करते हैं, नाउ लाइक आई सेड अगेन दैट इज स्लाइटली स्टिल अ ग्रे एरिया. इन मेनी अ केसेस व्हाट पार्टीज डू इज वो अग्री कर लेते हैं कि द फीस ऑफ द आर्बिट्रल ट्रिब्यूनल विल बी एक्स वाई जेड अमाउंट. हाउएवर आर्बिट्रेटर हैज एन ऑप्शन इन दैट केस टू ईदर एक्सेप्ट दैट फी व्हेन ही और शी इज एक्सेप्टिंग द अपॉइंटमेंट, और देन से कि नहीं जो आर्बिट्रेशन एक्ट का चौथा शेड्यूल है उसमें लिखा हुआ है दैट दिस इज द फी दैट इज पेएबल टू मी, सो द आर्बिट्रेटर विल डिमांड दैट. बट टू द एक्सटेंट पॉसिबल यू कैन ट्राई टू यू नो क्लैरिफाई एज मच एज पॉसिबल. तो ये दीज आर द बेसिक थिंग्स दैट नीड टू बी केप्ट इन माइंड. एक बहुत अच्छा कॉन्सेप्ट विच इज नाउ कमिंग अप इज इंस्टीट्यूशनल आर्बिट्रेशन,
ओके,
विच इज essentially to counteract this whole idea of arbitration fees being very high and this that. So as an example, basically what an institutional arbitration refers to is that both parties agree that dispute will be resolved by arbitration, but XYZ institutions ke rules ke hisab se hoga. And you have these institutions now. Ye abroad to bahut saalon se hai. India mein ab पिछले कुछ सालों में पिकअप कर रहा है ये कॉन्सेप्ट. पुणे में है, यू हैव द इंडियन लॉ सोसाइटी सेंटर फॉर आर्बिट्रेशन एंड मीडिएशन. सो जो ILS लॉ कॉलेज है, दे हैव फ्यू ऑफ आई मीन द सोसाइटी हैज कम टुगेदर एंड दे हैव सेट अप दिस सेंटर. उसमें एडवांटेजेस ये हैं कि उनके अपने रूल्स हैं, सो पार्टीज कैन अग्री फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट एंड दे हैव एक्सटेंसिव रूल्स. सो पार्टीज कैन अग्री कि इट विल हैपन एज पर दीज रूल्स. The for certain claims, and they have identified this issue that arbitration cost ek bahut bada problem hai. So what they have done is for small claims, as they call it, or claims up to a certain value, you have a prefixed schedule of fees which is extremely cost effective. So in but people aren't aware of this. So the as that picks up, this is something that you know will. Really aid. Time तो वैसे भी cut short करता ही था arbitration, but once this happens, expense will also be cut short. So if possible, we should try to have the arbitration done as per the rules of some such institution of repute. But by and large, yes, you need to have the an idea as to where the arbitration will take place. So seat B, the number of arbitrators. See your fees.
Yeah. So shifting this arbitration to real estate, which is our subject.
Yes.
So
yes.
Tell me, How is this done in real estate? Of course, we understood a broader idea. किस तरह ये किया जा सकता है? Real estate में इसको और किस तरह implement किया जा सकता है और किया हो रहा है? And इसमें RERA का रोल क्या निकाला जा सकता है? Kind of can arbitration replace RERA? अगर हम arbitration ले रहे तो RERA लेने की जरूरत नहीं है या उनके पास नहीं जाने की जरूरत है, ऐसा हो सकता है?
Sir, now what has happened is RERA has of course come in 2016. And RERA basically law में एक concept है of a specialized statute or a specialized forum जो बोलते हैं. Statute means law.
Yeah.
Now the argument in favor of RERA is that RERA is a specialized law, and so any dispute between a allottee and a promoter or developer should go to the RERA. Unfortunately, जो intent था starting RERA, I don't believe that's being fulfilled because the pendency is extremely alarming in the RERA. Pendency of cases जो एक बाकी जगहों पे issue वैसे भी था, वो यहाँ भी हो गया है.
अच्छा.
So parties agree to arbitration, but the difficulty is कि अगर एक RERA agreement है, तो now the parties, if one party insists that this should go before the RERA only, an arbitrator cannot hear the dispute. For the simple reason that RERA is a specialized forum. So any dispute between an allottee and a promoter, developer, whatever, that will have to go to the RERA. That said, however, in many cases, these arbitration clauses were there. RERA had not come into force, for example, wo to 16 mein hi aaya. And so disputes arose after that. So even now, many courts are taking the view. Some are taking the view that only RERA has jurisdiction. Some are taking the view that no, if there is an arbitration agreement, so arbitrator can also be appointed. Just because RERA is in place doesn't mean ki arbitration nahi ho sakta hai. Ab isme dusri ek aur cheez aise hoti hai ki ek flat purchaser ya allottee jo hota hai, uska second option is, or before RERA, most people were aware of the consumer forum, jo consumer court jo bolte. So consumer court also will not cannot necessarily be replaced by arbitration. If prior to RERA you had the consumer court, so yeah, usually parties would go there.
Yeah.
So ek judgment aaya tha 2018 mein Supreme Court ka, which said ki if there exists a dispute and if one party says ki nahi mujhe to consumer court hi jana hai, so then you cannot enforce the arbitration agreement. But all that said, if does that mean, or is it to say ki arbitration bilkul nahi ho sakta hai? Nahi, aise nahi hai. Consent of both parties is required. If one party says ki nahi ye RERA ke samne hi jayega,
so RERA, I'm losing a voice, Aman.
No, I said that if one of the parties says ki nahi ye dispute RERA ke samne hi ja sakta hai,
haan,
so it will have to go to the RERA.
To RERA only. So yes, both coexist. RERA bhi chalega, arbitration bhi chalega, is what I understand from your broader view. In terms of RERA.
They coexist, sir. But once you choose, there is a slight distinction. Distinction is that if, supposing I am an allottee and you are a developer. Now we have some dispute and I say that, sir, there is a dispute between us and I want to invoke, हमारे agreement में है, arbitration clause है. तो मैं कहता हूँ कि sir, I want to go to the RERA. Now you will respond by saying कि नहीं, तुम नहीं जा सकते. हमारा तो arbitration clause है. तो अगर मैं RERA जाता हूँ, तो आप मुझको रोक नहीं सकते, is all I'm saying.
Okay.
Yes.
Got it.
उस केस में RERA ही decide करेगा.
Aman, मुझे ये बताइए, what kind of disputes are being referred to arbitration? What are the current trends?
Sir, the first and foremost, I can make one broad statement. Disputes which are usually very technical in nature, they are being referred to arbitration. So, okay. And this is something which has been there from the beginning. If you see, any contract that has been awarded by the NHAI or the NTPC, jo basically PSUs hain, or things like that in infrastructure, construction, so on and so forth. Arbitration clause hota hi hota hai. Each mein ek circular aaya tha shayad government ka ki above any dispute above 10 crores, the contractor should think before having arbitration clauses. But ye sab matlab ye cyclical hai, ye chalta rehta hai kuch na kuch naya. But by and large, infrastructure mein sabse zyada arbitration ye hota hai. Between in real estate, aapke jo development agreement ya JVs hote hain, arbitrations inevitably happen in those.
Okay.
I believe most bulk of most arbitration that is happening at the moment, at least in Pune, would be these kinds of disputes.
Okay.
Between developers and landowners, that and the other. Apart from that, sir, to specifically refer to disputes, you have a lot of arbitration happening in basically the IT space, so to speak, now, where you have two parties which are both into information technology and services. Unke beech mein disputes hote hain. And because these are so technical in nature that ek judge baith ke, it is impossible for a judge to listen to these. Because the amount of time it takes to really hear a dispute of this kind is a lot. But yes, sir. So in that sense, anything which is commercial and anything which is high value and anything which needs to be resolved, there is an urgency. Usually you will see arbitration happening. But there are also, and this is one thing that people sometimes may not know. And of course, why should they? They aren't lawyers. But by and large, this is something that is important. Each and every kind of dispute cannot be arbitrated. So yeah. Law mein, there is a concept of arbitrability. Meaning, ke, is this dispute capable of being settled by arbitration? So usme, as an example, mein, agar aapko doon, to, there are anything related to mortgage actions between banks, mortgage or mortgagee, those cannot be referred to arbitration. Right. You have a lot of other disputes. For instance, there are many cases, but disputes relating to trusts cannot be referred to arbitration. So some exceptions are also there. But by and large, everything civil or commercial can, and given the last 10 years, the trends over the last 10 years, usually goes to arbitration.
Yeah. On any incidents that you would like to narrate, jo aapke zindagi mein abhi aapne itne saal se aap independently bhi kar rahe, you also work for some firms. So any incidents that stands out, jo aapko abhi bhi yaad aata hai ki, you know, that was an learning for you, kuch seekh di aapko usme. You would want to narrate that.
Hai toh bahut saare, sir. Yes, I mean, as lawyers, we are constantly learning on the job in so many ways, all the time.
Yeah.
But I think the one thing that I have seen is, especially, and I'm going to, you know, link this contextually to arbitration also. A lot of times, a lot of people will, you know, raise dispute, raise claims. And when it starts, it starts with a different gusto. Start hota hai. But, and usme hota hai ki aap us samay ekdam in the heat of the moment, you will end up, you know, doing things, file cases, initiate arbitration, whatever it may be, other different things. But these things, the justice delivery system, jo bolte hai, that itself takes time. Takes time. Yeah. So midway through, for a lawyer, it's his or her job to continue. It's business as usual in that sense. But for a client, many a times hota hai ki, somewhere in the middle, unko realization tab dawn hota hai ki, okay, maybe I have gotten myself into something which I should not have gotten. So it's very important, I feel, to know and be very honest in our minds that, okay, fine, is this something which I really want to pursue? And like I said, this usually happens at the evidence stage, sir. Because wahan pe hota ye hai ki, now, you know, it's till then you can still keep saying things. Irrespective of whether they stick or don't stick. But at that stage, usually in, at trial, you need to come through with everything that you've been saying. So my point is that I've had this experience multiple times where you know, parties are not realistic in terms of what their case is. वो एक चीज मैंने सीखी है कि I comb through what I get from my clients now. Okay, fine. If you are saying this, what is the basis on which you say this? That has been my biggest learning. Because quite frankly, sir, what happens is, and I'll say this may not necessarily be the best thing to say on this platform, but as lawyers, a lot of lawyers tend to complicate the law. Yeah. Or make it seem to be something that it's, you know, किसी तरह का rocket science है कि yes, it's not you know, it's very simple, it's not light reading, but it's all based on common sense at the end of the day. उसके अलावा तो कुछ और नहीं हो सकता.
हाँ.
तो basic rules of logic will apply, you know, whether you're looking at the law or even otherwise. बेसिक लॉजिक डिटेट्स की अगर आपके पास कोई आप कुछ कहते हैं तो उसका प्रूफ होना चाहिए, अगर नहीं है तो मत बोलिए. बट ये नहीं होता है इन दैट मोमेंट व्हेन यू नो पीपल आर इन द हीट ऑफ द मोमेंट और पीपल आर ऑन दैट इन दैट जोन सो टू स्पीक दीस थिंग्स दे लूज. सो टू हैव इंटेलिजेंट ऑब्जेक्टिविटी इज माय बिगेस्ट लेसन
एस्पेशियली एज व्हाट यू आर सेइंग इज करेक्ट. जैसे आपने कहा कि कई लॉयर्स का ये काम होता है कि पहले वो उसको चीज को उलझा दीजिए फिर वो सुलझाते रहिए एंड टेक टाइम एंड मनी एंड एवरीथिंग और दोनों पार्टीज का टाइम उसमें खराब होता है. द पर्सन हु नोज हार्ड ऑफ हार्ट दैट ये केस उसके फेवर में नहीं होने वाला है बट ही स्टिल हैज टू परस्यू दैट वो बस इज ओनली बाइंग टाइम टू डू दैट.
एग्जैक्टली एग्जैक्टली. एक बहुत दिस वन स्मॉल एनेक्डोट सर. So what, yeah. I've read this in some book, in a high court, I think in the Bombay High Court or the Supreme Court, kuch hearing chal rahi thi. So there was a very senior advocate, very prominent, he was arguing and koi ek dusra advocate tha opposite side, wo junior tha kafi. So the junior started arguing, to wo jo senior tha, he interrupted him and he said ki, you know, it's not as simple as you're making it out to be. Before the judge, he said that to the junior. So now the advocate was a senior advocate. So the junior said, "Yeah, kya main bolun bhi to kya bolun?" He let it slide. So the judge intervened at that time, and he said that. But his job as a lawyer is to make complicated things simple. So, right? So I mean, that says it all, right?
You know. Aman, we have had a fabulous understanding.
Yes.
We have understood the broad outline of arbitration process, like how it begins, yes. How to appoint an arbitrator, who can be an arbitrator, yes. He has to be qualified.
Yes.
How much time does it take? You give a timeline that this is how it moves.
Yes.
And what happens once the award is passed is what you explained us.
So,
then what about appeals? They can further go in appeals. In case they feel that they are not satisfied with the award.
I will just clarify one thing, sir, on this. I believe we have discussed in detail how the arbitrator will be appointed, costs, timelines, what is to be kept in mind by and large. Just one thing that I'd like to touch on for your viewers so that they have a complete picture is appeals.
Yeah.
So I'll just give one test case and leave it at that. Assume that one arbitration happens. मैं claimant था arbitration में, मेरे favour में award आ गया, and अब जो opposite party है, उन्होंने appeal file की. हम assume करते हैं for this purpose कि seat of arbitration जो है वो पुणे है. तो जो appeal file होगा, opposite party पहले जाएगी commercial court in पुणे, district court. वहीं there is a commercial court which is designated. वो वहाँ पे file होगी appeal. Parallelly मैं तब फाइल करूंगा एप्लीकेशन बिफोर दैट कोर्ट सेइंग दैट लुक ठीक है सुन लीजिए आप अपील कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है बट मीन टाइम यू टेल देम टू डिपॉजिट द अमाउंट इरिस्पेक्टिव आफ्टर दैट सपोजिंग लेट अस से दैट द कमर्शियल कोर्ट रिजेक्ट्स दैट अपील डिसमिस कर दी उसके बाद में द अदर साइड विल हैव द ऑप्शन टू गो टू द बॉम्बे हाई कोर्ट.
ओके
अज्यूम दैट द बॉम्बे हाई कोर्ट ऑल्सो rejects that appeal, that person will still have the last resort or remedy to go to the Supreme Court. and the buck will finally stop at the Supreme Court. So I just thought that complete picture should be there. So, but irrespective, if you have gotten to a point where you are able to withdraw at least a substantial sum of what has been awarded to you after the award itself, that in and of itself is the biggest incentive, sir, to arbitrate.
Correct. But isme provision hai, one can go till Supreme Court.
Yes, absolutely.
That is important.
So to after know. Arbitration, there are three more rounds in that sense.
Okay.
Of course, they will not, they will be very summary, but that does not, they will not entail a proper appeal process in that sense, but they are there nevertheless. And the time, you know, it will take the time that it takes.
Yeah.
So the very only way to is the deposit part of it.
Yeah. Aman, bahut acha aaj hamara ye session raha hai. Main samajhta hu ki व्यूअर्स बहुत सारी चीजें टेक अवे जिससे ले जाएंगे एंड आर्बिट्रेशन के बारे में बहुत कम नॉलेज और अवेयरनेस है मार्केट में और जैसे हमारे प्रोफेशन में भी बहुत कम लोग आर्बिट्रेशन से पाला पड़ा होगा किसी का तो मैं आई थिंक दिस इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी वेरी यूजफुल टेक अवे फ्रॉम मेनी पीपल हु गेट इन टू कॉन्ट्रैक्ट पीपल हु आर प्रैक्टिसिंग रियल एस्टेट पीपल आर प्रैक्टिसिंग अदर बिजनेस बिकॉज आर्बिट्रेशन तो हर चीज को कॉमन है वेदर इट इज रियल एस्टेट और नॉन रियल एस्टेट आर्बिट्रेशन तो हर चीज को एनी कॉन्ट्रैक्ट आर्बिट्रेशन इज कैन बी अ पार्ट ऑफ इट एंड दिस इज अनदर वे ऑफ अवॉइडिंग द कोर्ट्स एंड ट्राइंग टू फास्ट ट्रैक योर केसेस और जजमेंट्स और आर्ग्यूमेंट्स So, Aman, thank you very much. This was a very educative and knowledgeable session. I thank you from bottom of my heart to come in and explain and guide us through the whole process. And I'm sure, work ke saath bahut sari changes bhi isme aayenge. And maybe someday we would again want you to come over and let us know some more information or knowledge about this particular subject.
Right. No, sir. It was a real pleasure, sir, talking to you. And thank you so much, sir, for some of the questions that you asked were very, I think, very important. These are things that a lot of people, when they hear for the first time, it comes to them as a shocker. Yeah. So hopefully, this will, in many ways, set the context when it comes to arbitration. And yes, sir, it was a really nice time that I had interacting on this session.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Aman. Looking forward to seeing you again. Thank you. Bye. Bye.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Bye.
तो दोस्तों कैसे रहा हमारा आर्बिट्रेशन का आज का सेशन अगर आपको ये अच्छा लगा तो प्लीज इसे लाइक और शेयर जरूर कीजिए और कमेंट बॉक्स में ये लिखकर हमें बताइए कि किस सब्जेक्ट पे आप पॉडकास्ट सुनना ज्यादा पसंद करेंगे तो आगे हम उन गेस्ट को इन्वाइट करने की कोशिश करेंगे बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया